Omracer here, and today we're going to be reviewing Silvercrest Waffle Maker. This was a bargain from a month or two ago, which was $14.99. So we're going to have a look. We're going to make some waffles. I did buy some extra kit. Let's have a look at the box. The Waffle Maker with three interchangeable plates, Silvercrest kitchen tools, picture of some waffles, 3-in-1 Belgian waffles, novelty waffles and donuts, as well as 3-in-1 750 watt, as well as rust-free stainless steel and a 3-year warranty, which is a little standard. If you look at the top, the actual waffle maker itself and what the waffles can look like, as you can see where you got the addresses and the barcodes and basically the item number. And on the side, you've got a bit more. Waffle maker, interchangeable plates, easy to change plates, stainless steel heating element with power heating indicator light, non-slip feet so it doesn't slip, as well as 750 watt power consumption. And basically looks like those when you open with little interchangeable things and more fragile in the barcode. iLag non-stick. It shows you the types of plates you can use. You've got the Belgian waffle plate, you've got the novelty waffle plate, and you've got donuts. And now it is time with trusty scissors. Do the unboxing. Easier to tear off and peel. It has been here for a month and a half. Isn't it the best condition of the box? But we're gonna have a look inside now. As we pour it out, we've got the trays and more trays, the manual, and then we have the waffle maker itself. We got the waffle maker, basically what you get, how it works, where the novelty shapes go, on the risks. Tells you how to operate. And tells you ingredients for waffles. Pre-eat the product. Quite nice to give you actual recipes as well. Like how to do basic donuts and more motif waffles and bow donuts. And glazed chocolate donuts. Which we'll be following one of those guides. I have my own way of doing it. So we're going to try that. And you've got the warranty. And of course, there's all in the manual in different languages. So that's the manual. Then you've got the waffle maker itself, which does look quite nice when you open them up. So basically, at the moment, they put novelty waffle mix. So that's quite a nice way to do it, where you have the lifting mechanism into it. So it just makes it a little bit easier to deal with. And of course the iLed non-stick does make it quite nice. And that's just a novelty waffle mix, which you can see the heated plate of how it works with the heat, which is really, really clever. Because of course the rings get hot. And then from there, you've basically got the other ones, the donut rings. And it's the same for the waffle makers part as well, which does make it a little bit easier. Now we've had a look of what's inside, we can now make food out of it. So I'm going for the donut recipe for this one. The waffles, yeah, they're nice, but I'm not a fan of waffles. But donuts, well, a lot of history being donuts with. Donuts have been one of the reasons I bought this. And for this preparation, we're going to do a little bit of my own twist. So we're going to go with the co-op batter mix, cocoa powder. I have no idea how this is going to work out. Let's begin. Right, so the first thing we got to do according to the instructions is to spray it with cooking oil. As people know, the healthy oil stuff like Frylight, that's really good stuff to use. Like that. That. Now it's time to lock them in place. Now notice there's actually small flaps and bigger flaps. The bigger ones go at the back. Like And the... bottom, yep, sorry, my bad. Like I said, I even get it wrong. And that's it. That's now locked into place. So essentially, we just turn it on and leave that to the side while it is just turning on. Now that is now going to go. As you can see, the red light is flickering. So it's preparing itself. Just gives it a little bit of heat for when we're ready for it. And now it is time to make our batter mix, which, again, give this one... So let's get some cold water of 280ml. And we also need an egg. You can see a lovely nice egg. So let's pour this lot in. Something like that. It's a bit messy, but that's what cooking's like. You never know, it's not going to be... And to be fair, 29p these cost for batter mix, where normally pancake mix is like a pound. You can see some smelling out of that. And you can't seem to add some cocoa powder in because... because you can. And you whisk it. It's getting better. See, now it's getting mixy nice now, as you can see a little bit more. Even though it is messy, it's still a bit more mix. Right, so now we have to now pour the batter in. And there we go. Now, time to make these donuts. So what we do, put the lid down. And then we wait 7 minutes. So as you can see, it is getting there with the baking temperatures reached its hottest, and we're seeing how much it's going for. Let's have a quick look during 7 or so minutes. Getting there, still a bit more to go though. Okay, Giggle, stop both timers. And we are ready to go. Let's see how these turned out. Oh wow, look at those little mini donuts. That's actually amazingly crazy. They looked nice and different actually in their own way. So now it's time to unlock that and get it out. So and it pops off like that, perfect. Leave that to cool down. We move our exhibit in the middle. We have donuts. And just easy to get a knife to take them out. Yeah. Sort of mini donuts. Not like proper mix, but for a simple idea. They do look good. They're so cute. And you can stack them as well. They should have made bigger ones. You could, like, say, have a bigger platter of them. But, we're going to do. It's not going to hurt. Like that. It will fall over eventually. 8 mini donuts. So now, we got the time to test them. So we're going to go for... because actually what you do is stack them like that. Stack them. Low mini stack them. That really is. So, Without further ado. Although I think I did this wrong. They taste nice, but these are actually very Yorkshire pudding style donuts. I'd say actually quite nice. Yeah, I could eat all those because, again, Yorkshire puddings are nice anyway, but Yorkshire pudding style donuts, well, new thing. Next, we have a bit of rare mix left of a bit of sugar and another egg with it. We're going to do another one. So now we are going to do Belgian waffles. Making sure those are in the lock position for both. Make sure the bigger side is exactly as it should be. Both. Bit of rapeseed oil. And then you heat them up again. If you notice, the light to go green before we can actually cook the batter. Now it is time to lift the flap and pour some of this mix in. I have no idea what this is going to be like. So it's like a maze. Have you noticed that? It looks a bit more. You want to make sure the edges touch. And there we are. So now, time to put the lid down and set the timer for another 7 minutes. Okay, Google. Set a timer for 7 minutes. Bacon. Okay, Google, stop. There we are, so we're now finally done. Let's see how these turned out. Wow, it has its good moments of charm to it, I suppose. It's alright, it's got a nice charm to it. Yorkshire pudding waffles, maybe? Again, yeah, the batter mix wasn't the best idea, but it does have a good ring to it, which, yeah, I could see. It's got a nice charm to it. Let's see how tasty this actually is. Mmm. Glad they added the extra sugar in that. But, we'll see. A batter isn't the really best mix for this, so you do have to do it manually as the best, but then it's not a fault of the waffle makers, that's just me being lazy. Because this is hotter. It does make it harder to eat. But you can always wrap it. And 7 minutes gives it plenty of time. I'm going to give that waffle maker an 8 out of 10. Good value. Easy to use, not too heavy, not too big. Could be a bit bigger, say like 4 big donuts instead of like 8. Anyways, thanks for watching that review. I'll catch up soon. Omracer is out.